Hey folks, so today's video is going to be about the getting T8 horses coarser for being able to make your dream horses, which will then feed into the dream horse video that I'm going to remake, and then the mythical horse one that I'm going to remake. Now, first things first, I just wanted to go over my alchemy stones one because I am making progress. So now I have like the feed items that generates the live silver cost, so it gets the actual amount of XP that's worth. So at the moment, pure gold crystal is like the best. You get 3.1 0.31 XP per silver, like per piece of silver, and then as you can see, I've started to get some XP values from self messing around. But we're not going to worry about that today because what we're going to be going over is horses. So obviously, there's been the change, so there's only T6 horses in the wild, and you can't have anything lower than a T6 horse. So I'll go into small screen so I can show things on the screen. So basically, one thing that I would recommend, because Videolytics is pretty accurate, they haven't done an update for it yet. I haven't found anywhere that has a calculator that's an update. But basically, they've got a horse breeding calculator on here. It's basically from Something Lovely, but Something Lovely is obviously being discontinued, but the calculator is still available. Now, your training mastery matters because if we go to the max, you're going to be pushing up into higher brackets, and then basically lower. It's going to be lower brackets. So first things first, you need a male and female T6 horse because they're the ones that you can most likely get. You can get T7s in the wild, or you can get T8s very rarely, allegedly. Now, if they're both level 30 or one's level 29, you'll be able to get up to being able to have a tier 8. In fact, you can get tier 8s as low as 17, so that would be level 20 and 21. So you don't have to level up all the way, have a chance. You're best off trying to eliminate the chance of getting another tier 6 though. But basically, just keep breeding until you get a T8. The other option for getting your tier 8 horse to be able to make it into a courser, because we need to get it to be a tier 8 to become a courser to be able to go dream horse, those are the requirements, is to use the horse market. Now, the horse market, you can see you can buy a courser for 1.1 billion, but if you're not wanting to lay that much money down, you just go tier 8. That's the only one on there, so you can't even get that one anyway. If you wanted to buy tier 6s, which are always on the market because people just capture them and sell them, you want to look to see if you can get ones which have breedable. If it's not breedable, then don't buy it. You could technically exchange it, which destroys the adult horse and makes a baby horse, but it destroys a male and a female. So basically, you can get an extra breed out of them. That is an option. But obviously, make sure that you get it as high as possible level wise to get that T8. Once you've got a T8, you basically just need to level up. And these are the skills that you're looking for to make it a courser. So it's got courser skills. So if you hover over the icon, I don't know if it does in here now. So I'll just quickly, I mean, basically, it shows these ones are the ones that you need. If I take it out, just so that I can show the actual menu for it. So if I press the P button, you can hover over this. I need charge and sideways. So basically, you just level up normally and it may or may not get them. This one already had the S skills learned because it was one of the golden horse tokens. Otherwise, it is quite hard to get the S sideways and S instant excel. But there is a technique that helps if you have a paid for currency, but they do get given out in events. So basically, I'll check it in. And then what you do is you manage your skills, and then you can go on to unlearn skills and then select either forechop or hindkick because they are most likely to be learned. So it gives you more chance to learn the skills that you want. And then you just pick like charge, for example. As you can see, it's a 5% chance if I go on that one. If I change it to sideways, it's a 1.8. It doesn't actually change on that. It used to like give you a higher chance on the one that you clicked on, but that doesn't seem to be a thing anymore. But as you can see, I'm more likely to get quick back or quick ride. So change the skill, get rid of a hind kick. I got quick ride. Now the reason that we level up again to get a hind kick again is because let's say we go change forechop and we go for sideways. You're more likely to get, I don't know why quick back's coming up. I just got quick back. Or was it quick ride I got, wasn't it? Sorry. So you're more likely, I mean, you could technically do it with quick back if you wanted. There you go. As you can see, it changed the percentage. For some reason, it wasn't changing it before. So it does change on whichever one you've got. I think it depends how many points you've got into it. So if I was to do this, I'd most likely get hind kick, to be honest. So let's try it again, just for like the example. And then I got quick back. So now I can train it and up two levels, get ideally, I mean, it might be three levels, four chop and then hind kick, and then change out one of them rather than changing out two. I was lucky there not to get the other one. It usually happens. But let's say we got rid of quick back because that's quite a high one, and we went for charge. As you can see, you've got 40% chance, or 42% chance basically, of getting one of the two that I just got rid of. So always level it up, get those back, and then swap it out. You'll eventually get the ones that you need, and then that will be a courser. So again, either you can go collect horses to go then register your male horse to breed. You can breed off other people's horses, but it's not cheap. And I mean, level 30s or level ones, it's not ideal. So you're better off getting your own, which is pretty easy to do. You just need to basically go to the shop, buy a catering rope, get a rump of Law Sugar. I said Law Sugar rather than raw sugar. And then I did not take the horse out. But what I'll do is I'll just show. So I basically am using a bad character for this. Because it's not actually my training character, but that's because I don't. My training character is basically now my trade character, but trade's been removed, so it's sat out in Valencia. But basically, what you want to do is you'll just come to. I mean, it's better to do it over Portaferia, but if you're based out of Heidel, you want to go capture a horse, right? So you basically just go out the bottom area. I know I flew over the edge, but you just come along this road, and then there'll be two horses here most of the time. This is where they won't be here because I'm doing a video. Yeah, it looks like someone else has already took them. I'll try and find a horse for the video. But before I change, if you go into the P screen, you can see your training increases your chance to learn a skill. So the higher the level, the more likely you are to get a skill. The minimal movement's not as important. Silver collection, again, not important. However, if you go into the mastery, it has horse capture rate, completely redundant now. Mount XP is important because it'll level up faster, so you can get through it faster. Also, I use a wagon. So that I can train four at a time, but I don't do that anymore. The Forest Path Wagon's the best because it's a sprint. There's a horse there, but I think that's somebody's horse. It's not a wild horse, is it? No. Yeah, it's somebody's horse. But yeah, so there's no horses here, so I'll just change server quickly. So basically, I'm pretty much sure I've covered everything. If I haven't, please just leave a comment asking, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. But also, like and subscribe if you haven't already. Helps to support my channel. Also, memberships are a thing. Big tip with the horse training game. I mean, they're changing it down to 5 seconds rather than 10 seconds, so you don't have to spam as much. But it's really, really simple, right? So there's a horse on this server. So first things first, you obviously want a hot bar, so you can just press the buttons. So then, just get in range. I did this way too early, not gonna lie. Once it turns red, click, press space in the blue area, and then you just walk towards them, press space. It's still 10 seconds at the moment, so what you can do is you can just wait. There's no need to spam. It gets to 2 seconds, spam it up. That went up quicker than I thought, but 2 seconds gives you much more time. So you don't have to be constantly spamming. Also, wait until its feet are all the way up in the air. It's much simpler. It just means that it will actually go through. Sometimes if you press space straight away as it starts to lift, it just doesn't do it. This one seems to be quite resilient. Yeah, so don't spam your keyboard, don't break it. Just wait until 2 seconds. And then once it's at 2 seconds, spam. Don't even have to spam that much. I could probably get away with 1 second, but just to make sure, you always go to 2 seconds. So then you just give it one lump of raw sugar. It doesn't matter about anything else. Then once that cooldown's done, jump on it. Now what I usually do, because it's better, is get off the horse. Take out my, yeah, the horse is getting attacked, but that's fine. As long as it doesn't die. Take out my horse. In fact, just to make sure that that horse doesn't die, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fly away. So you just take your horse back like normal and then register it. Now they're no longer just level one as well, so it's quite helpful. You can see like how useful it's going to be. Also, one thing that I didn't mention is when you're breeding to try and get your T8, if you have a lower level courser, so like two level sixes that you're leveling up, and they're both coursers. So there you go. Because I was flying, it teleported to me, so it's much quicker. Make sure I talk to the right person. So register it, name it Alicia. I can't even spell Alicia, but we're going with Alicia. Like that. So it's a level two, has two skills. That's already a good start. Yeah, they're not the really important ones, but great start. You can start leveling that one up AFK. Could put both of these on my thing, but it's a case of that's how quick it is. Just go capture horses, bring them back, and then just keep leveling them up and breed them. Use that calculator, as I said. Anyway, this has gone on for long enough, so I'm going to end this here. Again, if there's something that I didn't cover, if there's something you're unsure on, just leave a comment. And also like and subscribe if you found this helpful. Ciao for now.